Church Online. How cool is this? It's really great to be here with you guys. Let's start with some worship.
I love praise and worship. When I think about a perfect God who chooses to show grace to broken people like me, and then that same God uses us to do amazing things on his behalf, I have to worship him. It's my best way to say thank you to an incredible God. So let's get crazy, let's get excited, and let's praise God.
One more step. As I fall away, you lead. Feel my heart as it's racing down the path you set for me. When the road feels unending, there's a promise you reveal. When these days leave me empty, you sustain me even still. With every breath, you are reviving these burning lungs. You keep me going when I can't run. Got me my strength till the work is done. Done. I won't let the race overtake me. Won't let anxiety phase me. Whatever comes, count me in. Count me in. Oh, I'm weary. I'm not gonna give up that easy. Whatever comes, count me in. Count me in. Count me in. Count me in. I trip up and you catch me. Then you lift me up again. You direct every footstep. You were with me till the end. work is done, done. Oh, I won't let the race overtake me. Won't let anxiety phase me. Whatever comes, come be in, come be in. Oh, that easy. Whatever comes, count me in, 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 count me in.
Y'all, I had one question. One question I want to ask before we get into Ricky and Jamie. What's your regular power? By that I mean, like, I don't have a superpower, but I have things I would brag about myself about. Like, for example, I'm kind of tall, and not everyone's tall, so that's kind of a regular power. My eyebrows, no joke. No joke. If you can look at these things, they are long. They go most of the way up my forehead. Like, I could probably comb my bangs down and mesh them with my eyebrows. That's my regular power. What's your regular power? I'm gonna give you a couple seconds just to think about this. Maybe talk to the person next to you about it. Well, regardless of what you think your regular power might be, God says that we actually have a superpower. Let's learn about that.
Did you know that you have a secret power?
Is it flight? One way to find out.
Oh, it's not flight.
Hang on for the loop.
3, 2, 1.
Okay.
That was awesome.
Whew. I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie.
Actually, Jamie, before we get started, mm-hmm. I need to talk to you about something.
Okay, like on camera, or did you want to? What's that? I've never seen that before.
I found it by the snack table. Jamie, you have to come clean. Okay. Are you a superhero?
That's preposterous. I would be exhausted if I were a Loop Show host by day and a masked vigilante by night. I've got to get my 10 hours of sleep.
Well, someone has been going around and helping people out of troublesome spots. Mm. He or she has been going around in a mask like this, calling themselves Goober Girl.
This is news to me. I have no clue what it is. Maybe it was left here for something else or by a previous host.
Well, we got a postcard and someone asked how they could save the world. So if you were a superhero.
I'm not.
That would be really handy. Okay, I'll drop it. I'll believe you. Saving the world starts with a superpower we all have. Because we all know, with great power comes great...
Costumes!
No, it's responsibility. Is your chair... Is that your phone?
Oh! This. It's actually my dentist. Yes, he wanted to check on my teeth. So... I'd better go do that, because your teeth are important. They're like part of your mouth.
Is that a pager?
Pager, noun. Also known as a beeper, a wireless telecommunications device that receives and displays messages. Popular in the 1980s.
No, this is my beeper. And you know what? It's actually dress as a superhero day at my dentist. So I'm so glad that you had this so I can take in and dress like a superhero at my dentist while he checks my teeth. So, okay, okay, bye.
Oh, she is totally a superhero.
Excuse me, could I ask, what is grace?
What is grace? I guess it's like when a ballerina is really good at jumps.
Oh, well, grace is what we say at dinner time before we eat to make our wings stronger.
Grace is forgiving others and forgiving yourself.
Oh, that's good too.
You know what? Grace is actually the name of my best friend.
Grace is forgiveness.
Wait, you're like half man, half horse?
It's called a centaur.
Centaur?
Centaur!
Centaur of what?
E-A-R, not an E-R.
Grapes?
Yep, grapes. They're like those little red and green fruits that you make juice out of.
Grapes?
Do you think grace can save the world?
I think yes.
No.
Why?
No, grace can't save the world. Anything that's free is too cheap. Grace is cheap, everyone.
Oh, it's too good to be true if it's free, that it?
Yeah, huh? Exactly.
You can't accept anything if you don't pay for it, is that it?
It must be a sham, I don't believe it.
I guess when it comes down to it, anything is possible to save the world, and I think grapes is in that category.
Who are you?
Do you want to know how to save the world? Okay, don't start with utility belts or arc reactors or radioactive spiders. Work. Start with grace. You see, no one can save the world on their own. No matter how hard we try to be the heroes in our own lives, we mess up. At some point, sin trips us all up.
Again.
But you see, God, he's given us a secret power. And that's the incredible power of his grace. Instead of punishing us for when we fail, his grace gives us his glory. You see, God's grace is a superpower because there's nothing else in the world like it. Grace, it's free. There's nothing we can do to earn it. We don't get it because we're good, and we can't lose it because we're bad. None of us have the right to grace, but we all get it. We all need grace, and we all get God's grace if we choose to accept it. The secret power of grace is yours if you choose it.
We all get God's grace completely free, and that's good news.
All right, I'm here. What did I miss?
It's not fair.
What's not fair? I'm sorry I'm late.
Why do you get to be a superhero?
I told you.
You're still wearing the mask, Jamie. Wear on your face. Superpowered face. I'm the one who loves superheroes. I want to be a superhero.
Oh, a challenge card.
Using only yes and no questions, you must guess what's on your cape. Once you have your final guess, guess what your superhero or villain name is and what your powers are.
Ooh, one, two, three, shoot. Oh, no!
Cape me.
Ooh.
Am I an instrument?
No. Like a musical instrument?
Yes.
No.
Am I edible?
Yes.
Ooh, am I pizza?
I think you might put it on a pizza.
Ooh, okay, am I anchovies?
Okay, close.
Am I goldfish?
No.
Am I trout?
Yes!
No way, okay, I am Mr. Trouter, a villain. Mr. Trouter lurks in the shadows and goes around throwing sardines in people's food unsuspectingly, right before they take a bite. It's like, almost like right before someone sneezes kind of thing. He throws sardines into people's mouths and people don't care for it. Mr. Trouter!
You are spot on. That's exactly what you are.
Oh.
Yes!
Wow. Fish cape. All right, Jamie, it's your turn.
Yay! I'm so excited.
Oh, wow. This is going to be right up your alley.
Fierce and happy? Okay.
Guess away.
Am I a food?
No.
Am I a musical instrument?
No.
I'm going off what you said. Beauty products?
No.
Lipstick girl?
No.
Groceries? Office supplies? Tree? School supplies? Sequence? Am I shoe girl? Steering wheel girl? Do I have Christmas lights on my back?
No. You're not close in anything that you've said yet.
Okay. All right.
All right, Dana, I'll give you a hint.
Yes?
You're the best.
Chocolate girl. An A+ paper. Does my cape have your face on it? Movie popcorn girl. Ninja turtle girl. Vacation girl. Puppies. Am I puppy girl?
No. Jamie.
Yes?
I'm in awe of you and all the things that you do. You put me in awe.
Am I Jesus girl?
No. You put me in awe.
Oh. Am I a, like, trophy girl?
Yes!
I have trophies on my back!
Yes!
Yay! I am superhero girl. I'm trophy girl. And I go around the world making people feel really good about themselves and giving them awards for what they're amazing at. You're amazing at sleeping. You're amazing at doing schoolwork. You're amazing at eating and... You're amazing at drinking chocolate milk. Everybody gets an award. You know who else gets awards?
Quizman!
When I say amazing, you say grace. Amazing.
Grace.
Amazing.
Grace.
It's time for the quiz thing. Have you ever sat down for a big meal and someone's like, who's gonna say grace?
Charles, would you like to say grace?
Or maybe you've heard someone be like, I'll say grace. Guy's great, guy's good. Thank you for his food. They're just saying, will somebody pray for the meal? So why do they call it saying grace? Where does that come from? Do you know the answer?
I know.
Is it A, grace is another word for thanks? B, grace is the lady who invented prayer? C, grace is what Jesus called prayer? Or D, grace reminds us to bow our heads? If you said B, you're wrong, but I extend grace to you. It's actually A. In pre-Elizabethan English, the phrase was saying graces. And basically what this meant was nothing but thanksgiving. So when you said your mealtime graces, it was a chance for you to sit and pause and be reflective and say, every good gift comes from God, even food. Every meal is a miracle, including broccoli. Yeah, I said it, and I'll say it again. Broccoli. broccoli. So we say grace and we also sing about grace. I mean, one of the most known hymns of all time is Amazing Grace. The man who wrote this song, John Newton, wrote this after experiencing what kind of catastrophe? Was it A, surviving tuberculosis, B, surviving war, C, surviving a bear attack, or D, surviving a storm at sea? If you said D, you know your hymn history, and I'm proud of you.
You got one.
You got it right. So here's how the story goes. John Newton is on a boat, it's 1748, and all of a sudden this violent storm kicks up, and he starts praying to God. And at that moment, the cargo in the ship shifts miraculously, and it saves them. The ship sails on to safety. That starts him on the path to Christianity, and at some point he sits down and writes this amazing song. Way to go, John Newton. Amazing Grace was published in 1772, and it's estimated that we perform this song somewhere around 10 million times a year. That's Amazing Grace, the song that we're talking about right now, Amazing Grace. It's incredible. Grace is another title that he could have used. Anyhow, grace is something we talk about, something we sing about, but it's also something that can be really hard to understand or even accept. Imagine it this way. Imagine that you get this really important test back from your teacher, and there right at the top of it is a great big fat F. You studied really hard, but you didn't nail it. And then imagine that same teacher walks over, picks up that test, and rips it right in half, right in front of you. Doesn't count. Your teacher just demonstrated grace to you. You failed, but it doesn't count. Your ship was sinking, but the cargo shifted. Your fridge was empty, but the plate in front of you was filled. Are you getting this? Grace is something that you can't earn. It's not something that you deserve, but you get it. It has no limits or no expiration dates. So what can you do with grace? What do we do with this power of grace? Grace forgives your past so you can be thankful. And grace sets promises for your future so you can be full of faith. God's infinite grace gives you the power to be grateful and trust him in absolutely everything. So, say a prayer of thanks. Sing a song of his promises. You are amazing because of the secret power of God's grace. I'm the quiz man. Goodbye.
Awesome grace. All right, so we're going to keep the challenge going. Jamie?
Yes.
Blindfold. It's time for another cape.
I'm so ready.
Oh, wow.
Yeah?
Oh, Jamie.
Hey, don't touch it. Don't touch it.
You are going to want to take this home.
All right.
Wow.
Something that I want to take home. So am I chocolate girl?
No.
Am I?
Just the cape. You just want to take the cape home. I wasn't giving a hint.
Oh, is it pink?
Yes.
Ah, I love pink. Am I sprinkles girl?
No.
Am I fireworks? Am I firework girl?
No.
Oh, not fireworks.
Remember the things I said yes to.
What did you say yes to?
That is pink.
Are there pigs on my...
No.
Pigs are pink. Pink bubblegum. Am I bubblegum?
No.
Oh, I'm a flamingo!
Yes!
I'm flamingo girl!
Yes!
Yes!
I go around at night. This is the theme song. And I save the flamingos.
I love it. It's catchy.
Thanks.
And we definitely have the license for it. Well done.
Yay!
Take off your blindfold.
Oh my word. This is amazing.
Don't you want to take that home?
Oh my gosh, I do. Look, there's little tiny ones. All right, round two for Ricky. You're going to like this one. It's a really good one. Okay. All right. Okay, what are your guesses?
Am I edible?
No.
Am I an animal?
No.
Am I a person?
No.
Am I not living?
Correct.
Am I a lamp?
Whoa. Wait. Well, no. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Close.
Yes or no?
Technically no.
Okay. So I'm not a lamp. Am I fire?
Yes, you are!
Am I fire?
Oh my gosh.
No, where? I am fire safety man!
Oh, that's a good one.
I set fires to let people know that fires are dangerous.
You set safe fires.
Well, no, they are very dangerous, but people will then be prepared for fires. Are your important items put in a fireproof safe? Too late for you to find out now. Fire has been set. I'm the hero that this city doesn't really want.
Yay! Oh. Isn't that amazing?
Wow, this is impressive.
That's really, really good.
Look at that.
Fire.
Oh, hanger.
You could save the world from fires, but not hangers.
Yeah. Oh, my only weakness.
They're your undoing.
Hangers. They're so tangly. Oh, no. Help!
I'm coming to get you.
Oh, no. I'm melting, which is
ironic because I made a fire! Entirely out of fire! Oh no! Oh, Hangers. My arch nemesis.
Grace isn't just a get-out-of-jail-free card. That's what we call cheap grace. That's a, I'm just gonna keep sinning because I'm covered by grace. That's not real grace, and that's not what Jesus came to show us. Jesus came to this earth so that we could experience the real power of grace and real freedom that comes with it. Check out what my pastor, Craig Rochelle, has to say about the power of grace.
I came today to tell somebody about the faithfulness, the goodness, the grace of God that is available to you at this moment. The faithfulness of God, the faithfulness of God. There's always grace. There's always the potential for freedom. He always gives you a way out. It's a little bit like video games today. There are so many popular games today. There's Call of Duty, and there's Anthem, and there's Fortnite, and such. I grew up in a different era. It was the era of Pac-Man, and Frogger, and Donkey Kong, and Galaga, and Dig Dug. I feel the Holy Spirit in the place today. I feel the presence of God today. What there was Asteroids. The graphics on Asteroids, they were unbelievable. There was a spaceship that was just like this. I mean, you could draw like this. And there were asteroids that would come your way, and you could draw them like this. And you had unlimited firepower. And you would blow up your asteroid. And then there would be little asteroids coming all over toward your little triangle spaceship. And so you would thrust forward and start moving around and stuff. And then whenever you were in trouble, there was a button. Oh, praise God, there was a button. The button was called hyperspace. When you're in trouble, boom, hyperspace, and your little spaceship would disappear off the screen and appear somewhere else. There was always a way out. There was always a way out. In the kingdom of God, there is no hyperspace, but there is a button that's called hypergrace. Oh, somebody, have a little fun with me. Our God is faithful, He is faithful, He is faithful, and He will always give you a way out. What do you do when you're tempted? I hope that you'll understand this powerful truth. Every temptation is an invitation to depend on Christ. Every time you feel trapped, it's an invitation to depend on the grace of Jesus. What do you do when you're trapped? You recognize He gives you a way out.
Great grace comes great responsibility.
Grace gives you the power to be grateful and faithful.
Hypergrace gives you true freedom.
All right, Ricky, are you ready to go save some people with our new personas?
Let's do it. Enjoy the ride!
Let's fly!
Oh, looks like this lamp is giving off too much heat. Fire!
Here hazard. I come, flamingos, I'm coming to save you all!
Oh.
Here ew. I come!
Is this a fire exit? I don't know, it's not properly labeled. Fire hazard! Oh, I guess that would indicate it's not.
Grace, it's your secret superpower. You didn't deserve it, but it's free. It's yours, anytime you want. Let's pray. God, I thank you so much that you have given us grace. I thank you that it's not about us, it's not about what we do, God, but it's a free gift from you, Lord. I pray we would use it more. As we continue on praying with heads still bowed and eyes still closed, maybe you're here and you have a really hard time accepting grace. Maybe when you think about God's grace, you're like, oh, I've got to do more. Like, there's things that I've got to clean up. I've got to get better. Maybe there's things that you're sorry about and you regret and you don't feel like that God could ever love you or you don't deserve His grace. Let me tell you the truth is that none of us deserve His grace. We've all done things that hurt God's heart, but that's why He sent His Son, Jesus, to die for those things that we've done wrong for you and for me. And He rose from the grave, defeating those things that through Jesus, we could experience God's grace, His forgiveness. Through Jesus, we could have a relationship with God. You didn't deserve it, we didn't earn it, but it's yours, it's free. All you have to do is accept it and receive it. Maybe you're here today and you said, that's what I want. I'm ready. I'm ready to give my life to Christ. If that's you, I want you to raise your hand right now. Hands up all over. As we pray with those who are making that decision today, I want you to pray out loud together. Repeat after me. Say, Dear God, I recognize that I'm broken and I need a Savior. Jesus, I believe that you are the Son of God, that you died and rose again for me. Jesus, I ask you to come into my life, to make me brand new. Thank you for your forgiveness, and thank you for your grace. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, Amen! That is something to celebrate because it is the best decision that you can ever make. And if you made that decision, don't keep it to yourself. Tell somebody about the grace that you now have from God. Let us celebrate with you. We're so proud of you.
You guys, even if you didn't make that decision today, someone who is watching this right now made that decision. I'm so excited for you guys. I'm so excited. That's the best decision you could ever make. Man, that's not just me, you know, throwing confetti in the air. That's real. This is the first day of the rest of your life, and I'm so proud of you. So what I want us to do, like all of us as a whole Loop Show family, is together to go to the YouVersion Bible app. If you don't have a tablet or a phone, I want you to go to Bible.com and look for the Bible plan called The Secret Power of Grace. We're gonna do this all together. If you have other friends who are on the YouVersion Bible app, I want you to start a plan with friends. If you haven't done one of these before, it's about to blow your mind. These things are awesome because at the end, you get to put comments in, you're like discussing, it's like a little chat room based around the Bible. It is going to be game-changing for you. I mean it. You're a smart person, you're gonna be able to figure it out on the app. Now what's gonna happen is I'm going to leave the screen. We're gonna have discussion questions come up. These aren't for you to just turn off the video, okay? I want you to find an adult, a friend, maybe a brother or sister, a vlog, start a vlog and talk about these discussion questions. These are gonna be good. Here we go.